let me first say that this is obviously a very tragic situation. I mean, my heart goes out to the family, and this is, when we get to this kind of an outcome, it's the least desirable outcome when our officers come across these kinds of situations. The fact is that, you know, we try and give police officers the most options so that the application of deadly force is always the last option. And yeah, ideally it would be great if every police officer deployed in an operational position in the Vancouver Police Department had access to some kind of less lethal option, whether it's a beanbag shotgun or a CEW, conducted energy weapon. The problem is, though, that when we have these options, you know, the opposite side of this debate is that there are all kinds of issues around our officers deploying with these less lethal, is confronted with something that completely different than what he was dispatched to, and that obviously resulted in this escalation that got us to this tragic outcome.
What do you make of the fact that he didn't know that the bicycle or the chain had been taken away from the Mr. Boyd?
Look, these are very dynamic situations that unfold in very quickly, and it's very difficult to perceive every single thing that happens at any particular time, particularly when you're confronted with what you think is a deadly threat. So that's very, very typical, and it's not typical only for police officers in terms of their perception when they're dealing with these difficult issues, but it's also very typical for witnesses who find themselves in the middle of what are very unusual circumstances. I mean,